Remember the janitor that we talked about in a small city? He, according to him, was called the N-word by an administrator in the school. He hit record on his cell phone at that time. He then informed the woman who called him the N-word, "I am recording you." She said, "Well, that's illegal," according to him. And she then said, "I will be connecting with the DA and I will have you prosecuted." He went home. Police came to his house, seized his phone. We have the video. Police came again to arrest him after he contacted the media. When the media called the police to inquire, they went to his house, locked him up. He makes bail, he goes home. They come to his house again and they said, "You have a ticket that you never took care of." There's another issue. Now that same janitor has been arrested again by another agency. The unbelievable story. Let me take you to the first video.
Yeah, man, how can I help you?
I can answer the front door, please. Receiving calls from here.
No one called you.
Again?
Why are you here?
Because you called us.
Nobody called you.
Yes, you did.
Nobody called you, sir.
Well, I can confirm with you, so please come down to the front door.
I'm asking you why you're here.
I already told you because someone called us here.
Nobody called you, sir.
Okay, well, front door.
That was the latest incident. According to the police, somebody magically called them to the house. The man in question said, "Nobody called you from this home. Why are you here?" Now remember the context, they have already harassed this man multiple times. And then they come to his home at 2 a.m. All right, so let me give you, let's put this picture up full mass. And I'm going to give you some more background and foreground, all right? Custodian at Poconos Mountain West Junior High School in Pennsylvania, his name is Galvin Dudley, was arrested on December 8th for recording a conversation with another employee at the school. Last night, he contacted Indisputable and said he was arrested again. Now let me take you to the second video, because according to Mr. Dudley, the police forced themselves inside of his home without a warrant. Here it is. This is so sad. After he complained to a white colleague about using the N-word, Dudley was fired from that junior high school. Dudley says when he told her he had the recording, that's when she threatened to get the district attorney involved and have him arrested. The cops did show up at his house. It looks as if they made good on the initial threat. Here's that video.
Well, we're gonna have to come in. Who's here with you?
Me and my children.
Just you and Rashad. How many kids do you have?
Three.
Three. Okay. They sleeping?
One. Two of them sleeping. One of
them. Well, we don't want to wake them up. Who is your wife or fiance? I don't know her relationship.
My wife.
Your
she's
wife?
Not here.
Okay. Is she working?
Yeah, she's working.
Okay. All right. Well, we're gonna have to come in just to make sure nobody else is here other than your kids, but. sit down and talk.
Yep, we got you. See, in the right hand of the officer, that was Mr. Dudley's cell phone. They took Mr. Dudley's cell phone, and according to Mr. Dudley, erased everything, including personal photos, effects, etc. He said even his Google Cloud had been somehow erased as well. Put up his picture again. This is a human being, a decent man, according to his wife, a very good man, an honest person. What caused this whole thing? A student lost a wallet. A student lost a wallet. Dudley says the administration requested that he come to the office for computer training. So he gets to the office. He says he was actually excited to learn a new skill. It was a setup. They then accused him of taking the wallet from the student. He said, I took no wallet. Don't have a reason to take a wallet. No wallet was found on him. And out of all of the arrests, ladies and gentlemen, since that incident, you know the one thing he has not been arrested for? Stealing a wallet. Okay? On December 6th, Mr. Dudley filed a written complaint at the police station about Detective Miller. Let's put up that official complaint. The complaint reads in part, on November 23rd, 2022, two detectives came to my house with a search warrant to search my home and vehicles. They took my phone instead of investigating the woman who used racial slurs and harassed me with disrespect and humiliated me. They violated my First Amendment rights. Now, Dudley faces many new charges after yesterday's pre-dawn raid at his home. Let's put it up. Dudley also received a ticket in the mail from the local police department. According to the police, he had a suspended license on December 7th, one day after he filed his complaint with the police department. Dudley did show Indisputable a valid driver's license that we confirmed. Let's put up this next one. The police detective, Lucas Bray, actually did respond to Mr. Dudley's complaint, saying the department's investigation, charges, search warrant, and traffic citation were all lawful. Here's the update. Pennsylvania state troopers came to Dudley's home at 2 a.m. December 19th, saying they were responding to 911 calls. Now, damn it, why in the hell are state troopers responding to a basic ass 911 call? Have you heard of that before? Up until then, it was one jurisdiction, now it's another one. There's more. Dudley was charged with 38 counts. Did you hear me? 38 counts of obstruction of law enforcement, 38 counts of calling 911 inappropriately on December 19th. He was also charged with resisting arrest. Dudley emailed a complaint to the district school days after, district school department days after the school meeting on October 13th. Dudley's email tells administrators he was called the N-word. And what happened? At a follow-up hearing with the school's attorney on October 24th, Dudley requested to play his recording of the incident. He said, okay, listen, we can just settle this down. The woman said the N-word, she shouldn't be around children. If you all think I stole a wallet and shouldn't be around children, this woman, being racist, should not be around children either. Let me go ahead and hit play. Everybody said, oh no, we're not gonna listen to that. That's illegal. All right, so he offered. Michael Levin, the attorney for the district, denied his request. He said, no, you cannot play it. He told Dudley in the email, and I quote, you are not permitted to play for us, and we will not listen to the recording that you allegedly made. It is alleged that the recording that you took was made in violation of the law. If that is true, then any use is not permitted. Dudley says he was fired without explanation. The school district and the police department have not responded to multiple requests for comment. Here's a photo of Gavin and his wife. Man has three kids. And we've had significant contact with this family. These are good people. These are damn good people. Dudley's wife said she told the police last night the number dialing 911 did not even match their own. I offered, she says, to open his phone and show them the call log. When I did, and they didn't see any calls to 911, they started to say it could have been from a text-free app. They told dispatch to call the number. When they did that, I took the phone and showed it to the cop, like, look, it's not ringing. They still locked him up. Let's put up the superintendent. Dr. Elizabeth Robinson is the superintendent of schools. And you're looking at the police chief. His name is Chris Wagner. Buck stops with them respectively, school district and city police. The police denied Dudley's allegations. A department press release states, investigators found no evidence of racist statements in Dudley's recordings. So let me read the exact quote. A forensic capture of a cell phone device not only captures content on the device, but also indicating the files that have been deleted. No files, videos, or other content has been deleted since the device was secured by police investigators. Press release. No evidence. Just a press release. Oh, there's nothing to see here. But they told on themselves in the press release. The press release literally says the N-word was not used. This is a virtual proclamation of the press release. That means the press release was not about their processes at the city police department. It was about proclaiming that the white woman who made the damn statement was not racist. Oh, there's no N-word on here. Look at that. Look at that. All right, Jessica, miscarriage of justice multiple times, obviously. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, this is just a whole string of events of someone doing the wrong thing for the wrong reason. And it starts with them accusing this custodian who cleans the schools of stealing. When I was a kid, I lost so many things that were me just genuinely losing things. It's how kids are. And so with no evidence of a wallet being stolen, why do we think this custodian was accused? Most likely because he was black, considering especially she called him the N-word. Would he be recording if she didn't call him the N-word? Would she care about the recording and say that it was illegal for him to do it if she wasn't caught on tape doing something wrong? Would the cops be pursuing this and care about the phone if they weren't in defense of racists? Would they go and search and seize property without a warrant if they didn't feel they could act with impunity? Would they then care about the traffic ticket if he was not the target of this clear racist goose chase? I mean, it's just one thing after the next. And my heart's really with the family because he's just been at the brunt of law enforcement being used in the worst way possible over the most petty accusation and racist behavior on the behalf of someone who is a public official.
Yeah, while not conclusive, Indisputable has been in conversation with multiple attorneys who are interested in this case. So I just want to make sure I say that because many people are concerned. Just know I'm concerned also, and we're fighting like hell behind the scenes to expose every single one of these SOBs in that city and state.